one of the most important steps you need to take to increasing your yields is obviously to take a look at your whole fertility program. Well, what we find is the most efficient major nutrient or primary nutrient out of N, P, and K is usually potassium, especially in the Midwest. So today we're going to talk about not just parts per million of potassium, but also the base saturation K percentage.
When we think about potassium, it's a very, very important nutrient. Obviously, it's one of the three primary nutrients. And one of the real keys this year in 2019 that we've seen with potassium shortages is lack of stock strength. And I've talked to so many farmers across the country, man, my stocks just didn't have much strength this year. And you think about the conditions that we had. We had extreme moisture in so much of the country, and our root system just had a tough time growing in many cases and growing deep in a lot of cases. So we had shallow roots, we weren't pulling enough potassium in. And it's tricky because when you look at soil tests, it can be deceiving because potassium is on there in a couple different spots. Well, let's talk about that, Brian. Where do we really need to look to even know if we have enough potassium?
All right, where Darren's going here is parts per million and percent base saturation K. So let me just explain the difference. Parts per million is just how much potassium's in the soil. The base saturation potassium percentage is how much potassium is there in ratio to some other nutrients. So the other nutrients in that base saturation test are hydrogen, magnesium, calcium, and sodium. And here's what ends up happening, especially in the northern part of the United States. There are some really heavy soils, and when there are really heavy soils, those soils hold a lot of stuff, right? Well, they are going to hold a lot of calcium and a lot of magnesium in many cases. So what ends up happening is you might say, well, 300 parts per million of potassium is enough for any soil out there, because when you take a look at the nutrient removal charts on how much a good corn crop is going to use or a good soybean crop is going to use, you go, wow, we don't need 300 parts per million, because in effect that's 600 pounds per acre. We don't need that much, right? But what happens is if you've got so much calcium and so much magnesium in the soil, well, in ratio, you simply don't have enough potassium. And when you don't have enough potassium in ratio, it just doesn't get into the plant. Either the magnesium prevents it from getting into the plant or the calcium. All I know is we end up short in plant tissue analysis. We have poor stalk strength. Even though the parts per million looks pretty good, if there isn't enough in ratio with the other nutrients, we've got a real problem.
Well, the parts per million are really important. As Brian mentioned, you have to have a certain amount of nutrient out in the field at least. But then the other thing we're looking at is base saturation to find out, hey, what's the ratio out in our soil, and will our root system be able to randomly find that potassium out in the soil? So when we think about base saturation percentages, we'd like to be at least 4% potassium on our base saturation chart. So out of 100% of the binding sites, we want at least 4% of them to be potassium. Now, that doesn't mean, oh, I'm at 4, I'm in great shape here for 500 bushel corn. Not necessarily. We would like to actually see that get up over 6, probably even 7% base saturation K, where we're in a really good spot. Now, that said, if you have things that restrict your root growth, you're still not going to be able to find that potassium. So you have to be really choosy about where you place potassium and what you're doing for practices out in that field so you can access the potassium.
So Darren mentioned 4, 5, 6, 7% base saturation K. What I usually tell people is it all depends on your test and who's running that test. So we use Midwest Labs real commonly. Well, 4% up to 8%, that's kind of the good range that we're looking for. Now here's one other thing that I want you to think about. We farm in the Western Corn Belt, where at least half the years we're really dry and there isn't enough water out there to support tremendously high yields. Well, fertility is ridiculously important, right? The whole thing is fertility is going into the plant with water. If you don't have as much water, well, how are you going to get the same level of fertility in? It's just like if you're going to take some medicine and you're going to take it with a full glass of water. Well, the next day you still need to take the same dose of medicine and you only have a half a glass of water there. Well, your concentration is twice as much. That's exactly what I'm trying to do in a lot of our soils on our farm. I'm trying to get that base saturation K level up a little bit higher. I want to be up at that 6, 7, 8%. Because I'm going for 300, 350 bushel corn. If I was only going for 100 bushel corn, yeah, 4% base saturation K just fine. Even 200 bushel corn, it shouldn't be a real big problem. But especially where we're limited on moisture, that's where we want to keep raising that base saturation K level, just because potassium goes into the plant with water.
Now back to the parts per million discussion and comparing that to base saturation K. If you say, I've already got enough parts per million, now you're telling me I need to put even more out in my soil? Look, potassium in heavier soils, it just doesn't move that much. It's not going to leach away on you. So building up potassium is fine because it's going to stay in the soil. So if you don't use it all up this year, you can use it up down the road. And when you've got a heavy, heavy soil like that, yeah, it might take a little more than 200 or 300 parts per million in your soil to get up to that base saturation level of 4% or beyond.
And if you have a light soil, well, it's very easy to get your base saturation K percentage up there because a light soil doesn't hold much magnesium or calcium or anything else. So generally speaking, when we start talking really high parts per million levels, that's only in the heavy soils. And in the heavy soils, we're not worried about leaching that potassium out.
Well, one thing we're worried about, regardless of which type of soil you have, is controlling our weed of the week. We'll show you how to do that later in the show.